a local Lenadoon commemoration event. Local Republicans from throughout the area and further afield gather at the local memorial beside us here. It's an event that's held every year. It brings together Republicans to commemorate those who lost their lives in the struggle for Irish freedom. It's an important event. It's important for the families. It's important to commemorate and remember. It's also important, we have a lot of young people here. It's important that they appreciate and understand the sacrifice that was made for the liberation of their country.
Oglach Tony Henderson, Oglach Tony Jordan, Oglach John Finucane, Oglach Laura Crawford, Oglach Brendan O'Callaghan, Oglach Joe McDonald, Oglach Maria Farrell, Oglach Brady Quinn, Oglach Patricia Black.
Thanks, Lauren. Could I ask for the following wreaths to be laid? A wreath on behalf of the Belfast Brigade. Lenadoon Republican Movement. The Rodai Society. And if there are any more flowers or leaves, please bring them forward.
Can
I ask you all please to observe a minute's silence in memory of our patriot dead? Can I call on the main speaker this evening, former hunger striker and MLA, Pat Sheehan?
Gurma agav, gomun puigas lev asin falcha agus asin coru hon lorch in shaw an act. It's more an honor I do sa a veig lorch or acoid mar shaw gaharaha nir tamaj baljahan shaw lekebnu or na hogli a fur bas or son sirsha. Thanks for your welcome and the invitation to come and speak here tonight. It's always an honor to speak at commemorations in memory of our patriot dead. And I think first of all, we should remind ourselves of what we have come through, and particularly in Lenadoon, and this particularly young people who maybe didn't come through it, and some of us who put a lot of this stuff out of our consciousness because of the changed times and circumstances that we live in. But way back in 1972, over 1,000 British soldiers came into Lenadoon. And I was reading during the week a statement from the army, and I'm talking about the Irish Republican Army. Over 1,000 British troops came into Lenadoon. They came in with 26 Saladin armoured tanks, 10 Whippets, and numerous other Saracens. And that was to come in and subdue the people of Lenadoon and Ogli na HÉireann in Lenadoon. They came in and they put people out of their flats. They came in and commandeered the flats and said, "We're staying here. We're coming in here to take on the IRA." And people had to move, and hundreds of people had to move out of Lenadoon. And all through the period of the conflict, hundreds of people were interned and imprisoned. Many volunteers from this area were on the blanket, on the protest in Armagh. And that's what we came through. And of course, we lost a great comrade in Joe McDonnell on the hunger strike in 1981. So, you know, we need to remind ourselves what we have come through and where we are today. And, you know, when we think about the purpose of commemorations like this, of course it's to remember our comrades and our friends and family members. But it's also important that we reflect on the sacrifice that they made. And last year I was asked to unveil, on the 30th anniversary of the hunger strike, to unveil a mural at the top of the White Rock, which depicted the scene when an IRA firing party fired a volley of shots over Bobby Sands' coffin. And Frank Quigley, who's another former prisoner, painted this mural. And in it you can see some well-known faces, people like Jerry and Jim Gibney's there, and a few other well-known people. But what that didn't depict was that at that funeral on that day, Bobby Sands' son was celebrating his 8th birthday, and he was celebrating it by walking behind his father's coffin. And Bobby Sands knew he was going to die, but he was prepared to make that sacrifice and realise that he was never going to see his 8-year-old son growing up. And Joe McDonnell did the same and left a son and daughter behind. And, you know, what motivates people to do that? And I think it's part of the human condition that people sacrifice themselves for the greater good. And there's a long tradition within Irish republicanism of making sacrifices like that. And people like Joe McDonnell and the volunteers whose names we heard read out on the Roll of Honour also did that. And as well as remembering our comrades, events like this present a bit of a challenge to us. You know, we have to reassess where we're going. You know, the struggle for which they died, where is that struggle now? And just a few weeks ago, as I was going into the Felons for Prisoners Day during Felon Phobal, there was a picket outside, people protesting that Marion Price should be released. And Marion Price should be released, there's no doubt about that. But there was a couple of old friends and comrades who were in that picket, and I, as I always do, I stopped to speak to them. And one of them said to me, "Pat, you know, what happened to the Brits out in United Ireland?" And I said, "Well, it's still the same agenda." I said, "The Good Friday Agreement wasn't the end of the struggle. And everything that we do now has United Ireland front and centre. Whether it's Stormont, whether it's building the party in the 26 counties, it's about building political strength." You know, the army wasn't strong enough to boot the Brits out of here. That's a fact of life, and that's a fact of life that we have to live with. But the struggle didn't end. We changed our tactics because we had to, and we're still moving forward. We're not up and storming because we want a job up there. Believe me, only it's to do with the struggle, I wouldn't be there. And similarly, building political strength in the 26 counties is not just for the sake of building a political party. It's about building political strength. It's about getting power on this island, and it's about eventually bringing about the unification of that of this country. And that's what we work towards every single day of our lives. Every morning we get out of bed, and I see a lot of comrades around here. And they're not necessarily up and storming. People like Bobby Storey. He doesn't get out of bed because he has a job in Sevastopol Street. He gets out of bed every morning thinking about the struggle, as many other people here do. And a guy came over to me, also on that picket, and he says the same, "What are you doing to get the Brits out?" And I says, "Well, I'm glad to see you're talking to me, because when I walked along here, you turned your back and walked away from me. I thought you weren't going to speak to me." He says, no, we go back too long." I says, "Well, that's good." I says, "What are we doing to get the Brits out?" I says, "What are you doing to get the Brits out?" And he says, "Oh, well, I'm just here protesting for Marion Price." And I says, "Well, that's good." I says, "Well, what are you doing to get the Brits out?" He says, "Well, I'm a civilian." I says, "Well, I'm not asking you what you are. What are you doing to get the Brits out?" He says, "I'm not doing anything." I says, "Well, that's okay. I'm doing something. You mightn't like it, you mightn't agree with it, but at least I'm doing something, and remember that." So, you know, what our comrades died for? They died for a free and independent and united Ireland. And that's what we continue to strive for. The struggle continues on. And we should remember our comrades and remember them with pride, all of them, and the great sacrifice that they made. But they weren't just IRA volunteers. You know, they were loving family members. They were friends and comrades. You know, they were multi-dimensional. They were multifaceted. And you know, as we leave here tonight, let's remember them as we knew them. You know, as a brother or a sister, a mother, a father, a wife, a husband, a son, a daughter, an IRA volunteer, a POW, a blanket man, an Armagh prisoner, hunger striker, revolutionaries, comrades, friends, volunteers, freedom fighters, First Aid Boss, our son Saoirse, agus our son Muintir na hÉireann, Gurm agaibh.
It's good to see a good turnout here tonight. The formal part of the proceedings have just ended. Pat Sheehan, as usual, gave an inspirational speech. He actually put into context the struggle and what we're here for. We're here to commemorate and celebrate the lives of our fallen comrades. It was also good to see a lot of old faces here as well, a lot of young faces, and good turnout as usual. It is important that Republicans in the Greater Lenadoon area, and indeed throughout Ireland, actually take time out of their own schedule to remember and recognise the sacrifice that fallen comrades have made, not only for them, but the sacrifice that their families have made on behalf of us, on behalf of our community, and on behalf of the struggle for freedom and justice in Ireland.